Hello, friends. Welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all doing well. Today, we've got some interesting updates to share with you. Let's start with SpaceX's aim to launch Starship by the upcoming month. Back in 2022, SpaceX fans had anticipated that Starship would launch sometime near the end of the year. But due to crucial and thorough testing of the booster and the ship took much time and didn't allow it to launch. As Starship is a very big step towards the future, therefore SpaceX has to take every step with caution. Ultimately, this led NASA's SLS vehicle to retain the title of world's most powerful rocket in 2022. However, in this new year, SpaceX sees great chances of carrying out their first orbital launch of Starship by the first quarter of 2023. Elon Musk had himself stated about this potentially in a tweet. On the 8th of January, Musk wrote, "We have a real shot at late February. March launch attempts appear highly likely." From Musk's statement, it's very clear that Starbase is going to witness an orbital launch very soon. But in order to go for launch, each and every component and equipment needed to be tested and ready. So let's take a look at how SpaceX is presently progressing. According to reports, in the last week, engineers have worked upon quite a lot on the orbital launch mount. As the launch mount is extremely crucial for bearing the load of fully fueled Starships during launch, therefore, they've carried out a number of stress tests on it in the previous week. Till now, during the cryoproof tests of Super Heavy B4 and B7, the orbital launch mount was subjected to more than 2,000 tons of force. But a fully stacked Starship will weigh more than double the maximum weight that the mount has experienced until now. According to some sources, after complete fueling, the fully stacked Starship will weigh more than 5,000 tons, so it's quite a big deal. Moreover, B-7's 33 Raptor 2 engines could produce up to 7,600 tons of thrust at sea level, and therefore stress testing of the mount to check whether it can survive that huge amount of thrust is quite conceivable. And to test out the load-bearing capacity of the 20 hold-down clamps that were installed on the launch mount, SpaceX engineers used their custom-built jig to stress test the launch mount. Report says that the hold-down clamps were tested in pairs with a load of nearly 480 tons, which was attached to the jig. While the mount goes through a series of tests, SpaceX cleared the way for transporting Booster 7 from the factory to the launch site. On the 8th of January, 2023, SpaceX had again rolled the booster back to Starbase's orbital launch site for the seventh time. Back in March of 2022, Booster 7 had left the Starbase factory and headed for the launch site for the first time. During its test in April and July, the booster had faced crucial damages and it had to go through a series of repairs. After that, SpaceX has completed nearly 6 static fire tests of the booster, with engine count ranging from 1 to 14. We know what remains after completion of those series of successful tests. According to earlier statements made by Musk and a presentation by a NASA official, it's evident that the last major standalone test between Booster 7 and flight readiness is a full 33-engine static fire. And completion of stress test of orbital launch mount, as well as rolling out of Super Heavy B-7 toward launch site, confirms that SpaceX is going to conduct tests on B-7 soon. While Booster 7 is in the last few stages of launch readiness, Ship 24 is almost ready. Keeping aside the necessary repairs, it has successfully completed 3 static fires. Out of those 3 tests, 1 static fire has tested out all the 6 Raptors present in the Ship 24, eventually qualifying it for the orbital launch. So we can easily say that Ship 24 is much ahead of B-7 for launch readiness. Musk had already stated SpaceX had plans for a real shot at preparing Starbase for a late February orbital launch attempt, and taking into account his earlier statement back in 2022, it's clear that SpaceX will first go for a full-stack wet dress rehearsal and then move to 33-engine static fire. This cautious step is taken to avoid any catastrophic failure that may delay the flight by 6 months or so. For those who didn't know, a wet dress rehearsal is a routine test conducted before a rocket launch and is generally designed to simulate every aspect of a launch except engine ignition and liftoff. After completely fueling the vehicle will have to pass through all checks necessary for a real launch. On successful completion, they'll head for the static fire. SpaceX go for first stacking, ship 24, and booster 7 again, and then head for wet dress rehearsal, followed by static fire. For the wet dress rehearsal, even they'll have a lot to do. Fast fueling needs to be ensured so that the propellant remains super cool, which increases its density and overall performance of the rocket. Overall, this test will serve as an all-rounder test of this Starbase facility, giving a good head start for the year. While wrapping up, we'll discuss Northstar raising $35 million funding for debris tracking satellites. In anticipation of launching its first three satellites this year for tracking objects in orbit, Canada's Northstar Earth and Space announced on January 5th that it had raised $35 million. The Series C fundraising round, which was headed by the American private equity from Cartesian Capital, brought the total amount raised by Northstar to just under $100 million, according to CEO Stuart Bain. In order to track other satellites and debris, the 24 Space Situational Awareness (SSA) satellites that would make up the constellation of Northstar's constellation would sweep the sky from low Earth orbit (LEO). According to Bain, the company wants to be able to track objects as small as 1 centimeter in low Earth orbit (LEO), 7 centimeters in medium Earth orbit (MEO), and somewhere between 50 and 40 centimeters even farther out in geostationary orbit (GEO). For a launch with Virgin Orbit in the middle of 2023, Spire Global is constructing the first 3 Northstar satellites, each measuring 16 CubeSats in size. According to Bain, it's still uncertain whether Virgin Orbit will launch these satellites from its California facility or as part of its initial run of missions from England. Up to 30 satellite options are part of Northstar's deal with Spire, and according to Bain, the business is currently determining when to pull the trigger on the following batch of spacecraft. According to him, they'll probably do it in blocks of 6. It'll most likely be another group of 3. According to Bain, the first 3 satellites have already received commitments from a variety of commercial and government customers, though he wouldn't reveal who they were. He claimed that a U.S. government pilot project that chose Northstar and 5 other private companies in December to prototype space traffic data platforms helped to highlight commercial SSA prospects and draw in business. The management of SES's fleet of GEO and MEO satellites would be aided by the data from Northstar, according to plans revealed by the Luxembourg-based satellite operator last year. According to Bain, Northstar's Series C fundraising round included a space development fund funded by SES and the government of Luxembourg. The Quebec government and Telesystem Space, a privately held Canadian technology fund, were also investors. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.